tank update for the 23rd, April 23rd, and today's Sunday. I just did a water change. I took a turkey baster and blew off all the detritus off the rocks. Everything seems to be liking it. And moved some stuff around. I put that Yuma, rainbow Yuma there, because it was touching rhizoanthids here in a little frag rack. It was right there. That's a blue hornet. That's why it's closed up, because I moved the Yuma from there and placed that one there. So everything seems to be coming along. I'm getting nice colors here on the zoanthids. I've started dosing a little something extra. I'll show you guys in a minute. Those two heads are more, much larger, and they're showing a lot more. Pretty soon, it'll be a small colony. Let's see if I can zoom into this guy. This guy's growing also. It's almost doubled in size. The Octos frog spawn. It's nice and fat. Looks happy. The zoanthids are growing out of control here. So pretty soon I'm gonna have to figure out what I wanna do here. This was a concern of mine, of overcoming all the clove polyps, that brown stuff. I'm not sure what it is, whether it's good or bad. Some people say it's some type of a sponge. And hopefully it won't choke that clove polyp colony. Here's a little cleaner shrimp doing its thing. This hammerhead is not too happy now because I moved it around a little bit and banged it a couple of times. Mushrooms are not that happy because I had to siphon. This is where all the detritus gathers in that section. And when I do my water changes, I have to move that rock and go back there with a siphon, tube siphoning, and take it out. I put this candy cane here, hoping that it'll get less light and less flow. I'm not showing any progress with these guys, having a little difficulty. They lost color, they seem to be retracting a little, they don't look happy. And I think I have to put them in a low flow, low light area. And that's exactly what I tried to do. Place it all the way at the bottom of the tank. And there's not a lot of flow there. So let's see how they react. These guys always open up nicely, the lady nooks. My Rhodactis mushrooms here, doubled. One became two, and they're getting larger and larger. Pretty soon they'll become three. This guy seems to be growing. It's healing in that spot there, I think, overgrowing. That bald spot it has. This is what I don't know what it is. Maybe you guys could tell me. Very good focus. That yellow stuff. I'm pretty sure it's some type of sponge. It's pretty cool if it's a yellow sponge. I've never seen one. It looks like a sponge. And let me know, guys, what it is, whether it's good or bad. Let's see. Fire and ice Zoas back there. They look pretty cool. Moving along. These are pretty cool too here. Everything is growing nice and full. I forgot to do the top down view last week. I mentioned I was gonna do it. I'll make sure and do it this update as soon as I finish here. Utter chaos, make it focus, growing very nicely. These yellow ones, I do not know what they are. If someone could be kind enough to tell me what they are, that would be really cool. Miami Vice, Zoanthid. Some type of Zoa. I don't know what that one is there. It's a nice purple, deep purple one, bright pink, green and peach. Another Zoanthid. I've got so many, I don't know what the names are. I think it's time for me to get some more different type of corals. Zoom. Focus. There you go. This is the other candy cane. That other one was in that frag plug spot right there, but I moved it way over there. Also, the Blasto here has seen better days. I think I had it in the light too strong, way too high. So I placed it here in a lower light, all the way at the bottom of the tank. Hoping it'll recover its color. Turn off the flow. I'll give you guys a top down view. I've placed all my letters in here because they keep blowing into the pump. Just up there. Anyways, let's start over here. Totally different view from here. Very cool. Those Captain Americas are looking very nice. You can see the utter chaos there. Dome. It has like a little dome. in the Kenya trees, looking nice. Lady Nukes, and all that euphilia there, torches, hammers, frog spawn.
Duncan.
Oops, I got another frag plug I got placed in that hole there. Couldn't see it from the side view. Oh, another one. Two. The green goblins have done nicely and covering that rock there. This one's on the screen. That's it, guys. We cleaned the protein skimmer. Still has tin there. Let's just dive back in here. Replace the filter socks. Skimmer skimming. I did replace the Kimmy Pure Elite bags somewhere back there. Another skimmer. This Octa looks pretty cool. Another filter sock. Cyclodactylus. I'll show you guys what I dosed today. I did some coral color, 10 drops of that. Replenish trace elements, 10 drops of that. This one was for increased coloration. They're all from Brightwell Aquatics. Coral color, 10 drops for the color. Replenish for the trace and minor elements. Restore, also from Brightwell Aquatics. It's for coral and coral tissue. Helps the color of the coral and restores any damage. Refuel, it's a carbon source. And it's for the phosphates and nitrate reduction. I did about 5 drops of this, 10 drops of this, 10 drops of this, 10 drops of this, and Microbacter 7, 10 drops of this. This is just biological filtration. This, I do it probably once or twice a week. It's phytoplankton. And it's good for soft corals, sponges, clams, and all other feeding invertebrates. Brightwell Aquatics. And every Wednesday, I do the Polyp Lab Polyp Booster. These are for focus. Concentrated coral nutrition and feeding response trigger. So right before I do the refroids, every Wednesday, once a week, I do refroids. But before I do the refroids, I put 5 to 10 drops of this into the tank, and I wait 15 minutes, and then I do the refroids. You could tell how the polyps get real swollen up when you add this and wait 15 minutes. Then when the corals are all swollen up and ready for that. Reefroids, they'll take it more. That's what I've understood from reading all other people's reviews and comments. And that's about it. That's what I'm doing right now. Alkalinity is around 10 right now. Calcium was 445. Magnesium was 1350. Nitrates were at 20 parts. Phosphates were at 0.1. What else? pH was at 8.1. And that's it, guys. Salinity 1.025. Temperature 78 degrees. And the fish seem to be loving it. Thanks for watching. If you guys haven't subscribed, please do. I do them every week. I appreciate you guys. If you like this video, please put a thumbs up. And share the video, please. Helps us out a lot. Until next time, thank you for watching and goodbye.